Hello again, and welcome to a traditional Kaldheim draft. And I've got to get to pick Tibalt. It's been a long time since I even saw this in a game of limited, but now I get to play it. Other cards in the pack are not that amazing, actually. The rare is miles better than anything else, so pretty happy to pick that one. And of course, I hope to be able to cast the Tibalt. Also, well, there's a land that actually helps me do that, but there are good cards too. Icebind Pillar is probably the best card in the pack. Definitely better snow payoff than the Blizzard Brawl. The other cards are not really even a consideration, so I could really take the pathway just to make sure I can at least splash for the Tibalt if I don't play black red otherwise. The Icebind Pillar is very good. Now this has a very small chance to come back still. It's late in the season. Well, I don't know if a season is the correct word, but late in the set's sort of a limited lifetime, because Strixhaven is going to release in 2 days. People don't necessarily need these lands anymore, so it could come back. But yeah, it's a tough choice. I definitely want to have the land just because of Tibalt, but I think the Pillar just has to be the correct pick here. Okay, Bodil Outrider, another snow payoff for green. I just passed the Blizzard Brawl there. So maybe I'll let someone else play green. I have to feed the Serpent in here. So definitely interested in that card, because I have the Valky, which is black. I would rather play like a base black and then splash the red to be able to also cast the Valky on turn 2 if I need to. There's also Finn, which is very good, but I'll take the removal now. Of course, I would need her to have a lot of, well, not a lot of, but some snowlands to play the Pillar. So far, they have been open, but they have been the wrong color. So here, the question, I think, is between, well, it's basically between these three options. The Flyer and a couple of snow payoffs. The Priest is better than the Grimdraugr, but only if you have a lot of snowlands. So maybe I'll just take the Raven now, just in case I don't get those uncolored snowlands. This will be fine anyway if I play the Pillar. Of course, the Pillar does require some number of snowlands to be played, if basically the card does exactly nothing if you don't have snowlands. But I think something like 4 snowlands will make the Pillar a playable card. Here it's a very easy Volatile Fjord, because this might be a blue-black deck. And then this is a snowland for the Pillar, and also a splash enabler for the Tibalt. So that's very easily the pick in here. Mirror Lake is great for green, but there's a snow swamp. That's very easy. Very easy. Black is somewhat open. I actually like these Grimdraugrs quite a bit in the snow black decks with snowlands. But now it's time to pick the snowland for sure. And black is open. There are still playable black cards. The Death Knell Berserker is a reasonable 2-drop, way down is fine removal, but there is a Hailstorm Valkyrie. If I end up with a bunch of snowlands, it's going to be quite a good card. And way down is a card I usually want to play as one copy. And it's quite early in the draft, I might find another way down still. I'll take this just in case I am able to find those snowlands here. Snow Plains though isn't that interesting. Nothing else here is that interesting either. I'm not going to take a Dugget Pursuit. The Yeti is pretty underwhelming. The Harbinger is okay if you get some number of instant and sorceries and foretell cards. I have like Ogre Raven here currently, and that's it. But I suppose I'm not going to play the Yeti, so let's take the Harbinger. It at least has the potential to be a useful card. Okay, here it is a decision between the Draugr Thought Thief, Eldefan Disciple, and the Skornevich. Now, as you can see, the black-red rare land didn't come back, sadly. That would have been a perfect card with the Tibalt. So, Disciple is okay. Draugr Thought Thief is okay. I actually don't have a 3-drop creature. I might want to have the Thought Thief for now. I'm not that big fan of the Eldefan Disciple. Now I might take the Infernal Pet. I do like the chance to get it to grow. And then there's a Pinter monster, fine, as like a one of Grim Draugr came back. Grim Draugr number two, maybe I'll take it. Yeah, I'll take over that. Okay, why is the white flyer that late here? Okay, so the colors kind of were open, but their cards were still pretty weak. I'll take another feed here. There's a binding the old cards, fantastic of course, but would require a green splash when I have the feed, which is final. I kind of hope to get the Blood Sky Berserker pack, and well, someone takes the Ezik. I can't really use that one, so let's take the feed. Rune of Flight, another Hailstorm Valkyrie, Simmer Drift Whale, Goldwain Peak, and the Rickster Guards Heist. I think it's pretty easy Simmer Drift Whale here. I want to splash for the Tibalt, and I still need Snowlands for my Hailstorm Valkyrie and the Icebind Pillar here. And also with the Grim Draugrs. These don't need it that much because the 3-mana 3-2 is at least a passable creature. But of course it's going to be a lot stronger when you get to activate with once or twice. But anyway, Simmer Drift Whale over the great cards there. Now, Crippling Fear. Of course I'm gonna take that. There is a Snow Swamp too. I would really want to have it as well, but you are never gonna pass this. This is an actual very high impact card against most decks. There are those kind of clumsy snow decks that don't have that many creatures that die to this thing. They start playing something like Lindworms and things like that, then this is not such a great one. But against most archetypes, this is just a very sick card because you can, you know, save some of your own guys. This won't ever kill shapeshifters though, but it's okay. I like the Ogre Raven over the other ones here now. How's the curve look like? Okay-ish. I have this couple Harbingers though, which I don't really want to play. Not that I got the very late Grim Draugrs, I might actually want to have. I would rather have the maybe the Eldefend Disciple than the Draugr Thought Thief here. Now this is a tough choice. Glimpse the Cosmos isn't going to be great in here. No Giants, no Shapeshifters. There's a Behold the Multiverse, but I still want to have the Simmer Drift Whale. So this would actually make my red splash so good. But then again, this does. This is so tough. That is a very good card, insanely good. But I have also the Hailstorm Valkyrie, which I want to play, and it does require more Snowlands. I also have quite a few playables here. Well, I probably will cut some of the Harbingers. I actually take the Simmer Drift Whale, and that is a pretty tough decision because the Behold the Multiverse is such a good card. But I think I just want to make my snow stuff, make it so that it works. And Berg Strider is a very nice pickup here. And here it's time to take the Disciple rather than something like a Skull Raid. Snowfield Sinkhole is no swamp. I think it's not. I have four Snowlands, which makes the Priest not that amazing. But I might still find more of them. And this does. I don't need the white for anything, which means that maybe I don't take the Enderstepped Snow Swamp. Priest is a fantastic 2-drop anyway. How good is the Rider's card going to be in this deck? I don't think it's going to be very good. How many Wegas I have seen? I think I've seen quite a few of these in this draft. So the card. I think it's just going to have to be something like the Recruiter, although it is very unexciting, but the Yeti is even more unexciting, I think. Now there is a Trickster Guards Heist, and I have a Brine Barrow Intruder. Okay, that's a reason to play these Harbingers and the Disciple here is to... I'd rather have it than another Binty Monster. And now I will definitely play all the Disciples and the Intruders I find. I think the Disciple is slightly better, so I'll take that now. Well, I got the pet, not sure if I want to play them. Nothing in here. Village Rites is a playable card. Warring Klex, okay. Not gonna play green here. I think I might even take the Scorn Effigy if I play these pets in here, which I might. I could just take 40 gems here. That wouldn't be the worst idea. Let's see how many cards I kind of want to cut here. Maybe the Thought Thief now that I have all these other three drops. The Recruiter isn't anything too amazing here. There's a tapped Snowland. I'm not sure if I can find room for the Scorn Effigy. And it can come back. I think I'll just take a... I'm a greedy guy and take a 40 gems because this pack doesn't really have anything that amazing for me. Okay, Berg Strider is amazing. I'll take Berg Strider for sure. And now I will find... I will try to now pick lands very... Snow lands very high now. I have four of them. I still want to have more of them. So even those ones that are intertapped, if I can't use them, well, this is the perfect Snowland. So yeah, I'm passing here stuff like pack mates, which is nice for someone, but I am very happy to get the ice tunnel here. But like I said, I would be picking and playing even Snowlands that only produce one of my colors, even if they enter tapped. Here, Race the Draugr is not so bad. I don't think I want to play two of these Hailstone Valkyries. I don't have enough Snowlands to play multiples of them. Raise the Draugr, but maybe I want to have one way down. It is a fine one mana removal. Usually at some point in the game you will have a creature in your graveyard. So I'll take the way down actually. Okay, Snowland, very easy. Oh, oh man. I said it's very easy. It was a very easy pick over the Priest, but there's a Na'vi, Betrayer King. I don't have that many. It's not gonna be that easy to get back with just five Snowlands, but it's gonna be a very nice card in this deck anyway. I have a zombies and snow creatures here. Okay. I really want to have the Snow Island here, but I think Na'vi is just too powerful to pass up. Another Berg Strider. Man. This is star. I'm gonna take the Berg Strider. I'm gonna play all these five drops. It's so good cards. So now let's see, it's 26 cards, and I still get to feed the serpent. I have so many cards to make though. You know what, this is actually going to be a Sulphurous Mire over the feed here. I have two of them already. They are still 4 mana cards, it's not that easy to cast always. And I really need to cut a lot of playables here still, and Sulphurous Mire is perfect because it will now also make a tip out easier to splash, okay. Wow, look at this. I could have had 4 Feed the Serpents. But to be fair, I have a very heavy curve. I can't play that many 4-drops, and the Swamp is still perfect here. So I don't think it's even that tough a decision to pick the Swamp over the Feed here now. And well, here is the Scorn Effigy, which I was about to pick, but I took the 40 gems with the Boring Clicks. Kennel Master won't be played. I have so many 4-drops here. 5-drops, I mean. I'll take the Scorn Effigy. It's a card I can maybe play. Another way down. I have one. I don't think I want to have another one. Then again, I guess I'll take like well, I guess some decks this might actually be a good sideboard option. Okay, fine. I'll take it for sideboard purposes. Well, here nothing is interesting. Well, I still got to raise the Draugr too, which is quite nice. And I did get a very late Priest here. Okay, so, and given that I had those Snowlands, I think I'll just can easily just leave those things at my sideboard. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that's 6, 7 Snowlands. Okay, so 7 Snowlands is definitely a reasonable amount for the double Priest of the Haunted Edge and the Na'vi Betrayer King. It's actually going to be possible to get it back now. But what are my cuts here? I'll cut the lands for now. I will be playing 23 non-lands here. So the Kaldheim Harbinger really isn't going to do much here. And now that I got these 2-drops, the Priests and the Disciples. Yeah, the Harbinger is mostly like something I can trade with the Trickster for the Trickster God's Heist. But there are not really a lot of things it can help casting. So easy cuts here. I still am interested in playing the Trickster God's Heist here. I could not play the Infernal Pets here. I could not play the Village Rites. Or I can just, you know, not play this thing. This could be maybe a sideboard card. against decks that have some bigger creatures, for instance. I have a lot of force in here, and I like the pet plan here. I have a few cheap cards here that makes it able to get some counters. Although the zombie rogue here does get boosted by Nafi, Infernal Pet does not. But I could see using the Trickster God's Heist as a sideboard card, which means I can easily cut one of the Disciples and probably the Prime Barrow Intruder too. Yeah, I still have, if I see my turn 2 actions, do I need them? Okay, I'm not so sure about the Raised Draugr though. How good is the pet going to be in the end? How about the village rights? I guess I could still... Interesting. Do I want to play the pet? I could cut the pets and move like the Draugr Thought Thief still in here. And but I do have a number of cheap cards here still. But maybe it's not the pet deck. So let's see, Thought Thief goes in. How many blue cards I have? I have still 9. And that's 23 now. So Bind to Monster, Village Rites. Maybe with the Village Rites I want to play double Disciple in here. And maybe... I'm not going to cut the 5 drops, I'm not going to cut the 4 drops. And I'm not going to cut the 3 drops just for curve reasons. Scornifici is kind of a 2 drop, that's the reason I'm putting it to the deck. The Raise the Draugr has some targets, 6 zombies, 4 clerics. It could be a decent main deck card. But I also could see not playing it. If I don't play it, this would be the main deck. 16 creatures, 7 non-creatures. Quite a bit of removal thanks to the priests as well, although that works mostly against small creatures. Okay, I will sideboard in the Raised Draugr maybe if it seems like a lot of creatures are going to get killed. Yep, okay. So the lands. Yes, all these will go. I didn't get any of those uncommon lands, but yeah, this is 4 ways to get the red mana for my Tibalt. That's going to be enough. And then I will see that... let's put the blue producing lands. Okay, so that's like 3 lands that produce black, 1 land that produces only blue, and then 2-3 of these that can produce either. So I will add 10 more lands here. I do want to have a heavy amount of black here and still a reasonable amount of blue here, but not that many blue are needed. Here is basically 4 lands that will always produce black. Shimmer Rift Veils might produce black if I don't have to choose some other color. So I would say I will have at least 5 swamps in here. That is now 9 plus the whales here. If I put 5 islands here, that would be like 7 blue producing lands plus a couple of Simmerdrift whales. I think that's enough, so that should be enough for both of my main colors. 7 plus 2 for blue and 9 plus blue, 9 plus 7 plus 2 for blue, 9 plus 2 for black, and then there are 4 or 2 plus 2 for red, kind of. Okay, I'll try it like this, and I have, this is a best of three event, so I will be able to sideboard into something else. I have quite a bit of sideboard options, including the Trickster God's Heist, which could be quite good against certain decks. Okay, that's only two lands and nothing to play for cheap. 4/4, 5 per village rights, which requires a creature. The pillar would be okay. I'm on the draw here. It's a tough choice indeed. I have the pillar, which will be okay. My 4-mana play would allow me to play the Feed the Serpent and the Valkyrie, although Valkyrie is not very good when you are defensive. The Berg Strider will be good. I'm gonna keep it. I hope that I will draw my lands here, that, because that's what I basically need. Okay, I do wanna play the tapped land. I think I'm gonna just say black here. Now that I have the one blue, and I have only one card that might need red, and it also has a, you know, mono black option, I have still three lands that can, you know, make red a thing. Okay, opponent didn't have a 2-drop, not even a 4-tell, and I did draw back-to-back lands in here. So now I can say red on this thing. If I ever get Tibalt, then I get to now curve out normally. I have the double black for the feed. I can have the Icebind pillar, and I am facing no pressure at least yet. So that was kind of a perfect. Opponent is also on only green here. That thing has to be killed, but I'm still playing the pillar now. Oh, I'm not playing the pillar because I didn't play the blue. Okay. Well, that happened. Let's see if they can find a creature from the top of their deck. Probably not, because they attacked, no. Well, that has to be fed too, but I have to, I just drew the other one. So that was a nice mistake by me, you know. I'm gonna get rid of this before they get value out of it. But yeah, I could have the Icebind Pillar in play now, and I don't, so let's see how that's gonna punish me. Opponent has a tough draw here, so I'm not that worried about it. I can just actually play the Valkyrie instead of playing the Pie Pillar. I don't need the Pillar now, they have only this as that 2 power. Play this thing, I have the Berg Strider up. And yeah, things are quite good. Even if I had the Pillar, I don't necessarily need the Pillar to be on the battlefield. Now they found their second color. So, struggle that, and then I will just tap it down first. The Berg Strider. Cinderheart Giant. Well, that is tough, because I actually think I'm going to feed that instead, and I will just tap down the other one then. Can't actually do anything else, but I have to feed the serpent up here now. They might find another snowland, then this will deal 5, but I'm still in a okay, they have more colors, and they did find the snowland. So let's see if they're gonna go for the activation. So as long as they don't have answer for the pillar, I'm in a good shape. But they might be holding something like a, okay, might be holding something like a Masked Vandal, of course. Well, this is going to be pretty nice. I can do this and play the pillar. So what's the last card? Just a land. And then I can start tapping them. I think I'm going to still take 5 damage from the troll. I'm gonna have to jump block, but I don't have to. No, actually, yeah, the point is that I want to jump block, but I want to jump block so that I can actually use the village rights on the jump. So I will take here damage now, and hopefully the fact I'm at 3 life total here is not going to punish me too much. So Let's see, I will need one mana for the pillar, one mana for the village rights. That leaves me four. So it would be nice to use the Thought Thief. But I think it's just going to be now the Ogre Raven instead. That leaves me proper mana there. Now that's very annoying when I'm at 3 life. Wow, that is... I don't have many blocks left. At least I can do, I cannot tap the one that is actually... I can tap the one that has the equipment actually, so that's not so bad. Just realized that. So I only need to jump block this guy a couple of times. Do have here a... Okay, yeah, that is useless. So I need to jump block. I guess I'm gonna double block instead. I could attack for 7 now. Let's see, I could go for the win too. Because what I can do here is... I can win with the Grim Draugr on the next turn. I can jump block with the Thought Thief. Of course, if they have a removal, then it's bad. But I will do this first. I will... use the Thought Thief in here and of course target them. They are responding to my actions because the Eyesight Troll activation is up here. That goes to library. So if their hand is not a good card, I will actually be able to win them. Let's see if I can play it safe and still leave an Ogre Raven here. So if I attack them to 12, next turn I have the Grim Draugr, which is able to deal... Actually, when I play the Swamp, it has 4 activations because I do have the 4 Snowlands here. So it will be a 7 power thing. So I basically could leave the Ogre Raven here as a blocker. But now I can just block with the Grim Draugr if I really need to. The sad thing here is, of course, that these are not a lethal attack. If I have to lose both the Thought Thief and the Grim Draugr, I won't be having a lethal attack. But I guess I'll gamble a bit because I know they are drawing a forest here. So this should be okay. I mean, the card in their hand should be something. I don't know what they haven't used. If it's something actually other than land, I don't know how they are going to win here. Please don't have anything, because this is gonna mean, yes, that I would have lost. So that was a land then. So they had big guys in here. Didn't really see elves, but that was mostly because they drew a lot of lands in here. And Tormentor's Helm feels a bit weird when they have these big hitters here. Struggle for Skemfar. Well, definitely I'm going to take the... Trickster God's Heist that can steal many of their things. Even the Eyesight Troll will be great because I have so much snow mana myself. The Crippling Fear actually doesn't seem that great, but it does deal with the Troll, so I think I will still have it in the deck. And now that I have the Trickster God's Heist, I might want to have something like... yeah, let's not play the Scorn Effigy, but let's play the Brine Barrow Intruder here. More cards I can give them. Then how good the way down, sorry, the village rights is. The way down is okay because they have the troll. Do I want to do something like cut the village rights for something like demonic gifts? Well, I have to cut something anyway here before I submit. Submit the deck here, so maybe... The Village Strike is of course good with the Prime Barrow Intruder and the Disciples. but the way down is can be quite useful too. Well, mostly against the troll only. Okay, maybe I'll cut the way down and leave the village rights still in. That's still 16 creatures. Okay, I think this is the deck. Yep, that's a turn 3 Raven and then a couple of Berg Striders coming up. All the colors, including the potential Tibalt. Frostpyre. Oh yeah, they did have an island in the deck too. Packmate. Now I can do a block on that thing with the Brine Barrow Intruder if they don't have something to interfere. Which at least is worth a try. Okay, they just do that. Okay then. I guess I have to leave my Raven to block then. I'm not gonna attack for 3 and take 7 damage unless I draw something nice right now. The Berg Striders will be quite nice, but yeah, the Inga is something I don't wanna do. Yeah, I have to be careful while the Inga is on the board, so. Just trying to make them not draw the 3 cards. Okay, they kept 2 on top, 1 on bottom. That's gonna be great. But now I have no other play than the intruder here, so let's just keep a blocker. Hopefully get rid of the Inga. Okay, let's see which one they're gonna... Okay, that's fine. Now I just hope they don't have anything. Well, they have something. I can interfere with my intruder here, but that's still pretty annoying. At least they don't have any good attacks now. But the problem is, Arnie will be... This chapter 2 will be problematic. I do need to find my Feed the Serpent or even just a Bindy Monster. Oh, that's a fine trade. If they have something like a burn spell to kill the intruder, they will get to draw 3 cards. But not much I can do about it. Okay, so and there is the bind. So the things are actually good. Because no matter what, I had a good turn. Thanks to the one snow mana I have available, I can tap down the packmate, play the Nafi, and then tap down it again. Now let's see if they're gonna make the Sentinel a bigger one. I hope they do exactly that. So that means I can bind the monster it. Oh, another Arnislaced Troll. Well, I guess I have to... Yeah, I might have to actually wait. That's pretty good stuff they have going on. Now, are they going to give another set of counters too? Well, Icebind Pillar is good too. So definitely things are still fine. I won't be using the Bind the Monster now because I need to see who they're gonna give the next counters. If they give them to the Packmate, I can still take the 7 damage there. Okay, now they gave it to the Sentinel, which makes actually a lot of sense, and I might be should have actually left the double block here happen. Don't know why I did that. Okay, this is just Well, I have to take this damage, and then I will have to okay, well, I can also, if they have a good draw, I have a fairly good draw myself too. So of course it's going to be the Trickster God's Heist. So this is a 5-5, and I will take the Cinderheart Giant. This is a 3-4, and this is a 5-5, so definitely I will bind the Packmate in there. Thank you very much, and then I can bind the Packmate. And now with the Na'vi and the Icebind Pillar, I should be in a pretty good shape. They get 5 life there. Okay, they have a Realm Walker, so they really... And now they have Warrior. Let's see if they find a Warrior from the top of their deck. Yeah, they got a lot of life here, so let's see if I can pull this off. So I can change what exactly. I can take the Frostpyre from there if I want to. I can never cast it. Well, yeah, actually I can. I don't need the blue myself, and I don't want them to get the scry effect, so I suppose I'll do it like this. Can I play this turn without... That means I'm gonna get the tapped land. I'm gonna play the Na'vi. Yeah, I'm gonna just play the Na'vi. Although this is my snow land for the Na'vi. It's actually... it's actually a tough one. I don't want to lose the Snowland actually, so let's just keep it as it is. Oh yeah, I have to target something and then. Okay, yeah. So that was. I could have done the switch, but this is not the Snowland and I don't want to lose my snow. I want my Na'vi to actually be able to come back. Now the question is, what do I do here? I could just play the Na'vi, but this is a 4-5. I'm thinking about the attack with the Cinderheart Giant still here. I think I'll just go for the Icebind Pillar after all. I can tap the things here. I could just double block these two. I could go for the pillar and the Draugr Thought Thief. But I don't want to double block it because I can make this a 5-5 when the Na'vi can pump it. So yeah, let's just do it like this. They are drawing, you know, top decking anyway. So let's tap this thing. They did have now the... They got the, another blue mana for the Frostpyre. I don't necessarily even want to play the Thought Thief until I have this thing up here. This will pump also. Okay, they lose. This will pump also the Zombie Rogue here. So now I could attack with both of these guys because I don't mind the trade on the Realm Walker here. Well, they actually can't even... kill it. So yeah, let's go for 12 damage here now. I can still use the pillar in here. Yeah, the Frostpyre doesn't actually do anything. It lets them scry, but that's it. Now if they want to attack... Okay, they played the land, that's generous. Now I don't have to worry about what might be in their hand. Should be in a good shape now. So now I of course let them attack because I'm offering a lethal. I can just tap their blockers here. So I guess the 3-4 goes away and... Yep. Well, opponent did draw a bunch of lands, but the start of their match was very good, but I was able to draw my important cards to match their plays. Well, where are my lands? Well, this is not great either, but let's see if the opponent mulligans. If they mulligan 2, the Elden Disciples can be quite good. If they keep 7 and they're on the draw, the Disciples will be quite harmless. No matter what, I think I'm going to steal. It's gonna be a Grimdraugr, or it could be the Priest of the Haunted Edge. With only one Snowland, it's not necessarily that great. Okay, opponent gets 7, sadly. I think the Priest shall go now. I will this at least, you know, threaten to deal 4 damage and be menace and all that. So do they have a 1 mana play? I just, you know, play these disciples. No point waiting until they have a fewer cards in hand. At least I get a bit more information about what their deck might be. And for example, whether they discard the land or not. If they discard the land, then, well, that's not much information. But if they discard a non-land, that means they are a bit land light here. So they kept their... Well, that means they have an Elven Bow, probably, because when they played the forest... Okay, that was the Elven Bow. Because when they played the forest and they didn't, you know... Did not, Okay, they have a Valky. Well, that's... I want my Valky too at some point. But yeah, that was the reason they hold the priority after playing the forest there. But the interesting, they got rid of that and they didn't want me to play another Disciple here. Yeah, I can start the race here. Their hand must be quite good because they lost the Elven Bow. That's a pretty nice card to have. Also a 3-drop. Well, I'm expecting to see a lot of good cards from there. If they attack with the Valky, I think I'll just block. I want my Disciple Black back. Or maybe not, I could also just start raising here. This actually can be a 5-power menace guy. Berserker. Okay. So they kept the Berserker instead of the Elven Bow, unless they just drew this thing. Okay, they are giving me the option to trade. Okay, let's trade. I want my Disciple. That doesn't do anything. Why would they do that? Why would they play Snakeskin Whale when it's gonna die anyway? Opponent. I think I want to... Well, they have 3 spells, most likely. Okay, I will play the Disciple now. Let's see what else they have. They just wasted their Snakeskin Whale for no reason. But I want to see what other cards they have there. Grimdraugr. Okay, well, those were decent discards. I got rid of the Elven Bow and the Grimdraugr. And now if I draw any untapped land, Berg Strider is a nice play. And then I can play the Grimdraugr in any other case. Or whatever I draw. Egon. Okay, well, that's gonna be surviving for a couple of... I guess I'll just jump block it with my 1-1s, no big deal. And also the... Oh, you know what? Okay, that was an insane draw. Of course, a untapped land would have been a very good draw too. But I could have locked it down with the Berg Strider, but now really. I can just tap it down. They will get a card from it, of course, in the end. But that just doesn't bother me too much. I don't have to jump block it now at all. Let's see if there's some other creature to play. I'm not going to block with the disciples. They might have something that boosts this thing's power. So I can just take the 2 damage here. Anyway, the Berg Strider will be able to block this quite nicely. Shadow Sage, okay. Fine then. They have two same creature types, so they made me lose some life. Okay, so it's a pretty easy Grim Draugr into pillar activation again. Why I'm cancel? No need to tap anything quite yet. So they will exile their last two cards. They, by the way, have to do it. They don't have the option to choose to sacrifice. They have to exile cards, and only if they can't, they have to sacrifice Egon himself. Is it him or herself? I'm not actually sure. Alright, so empty graveyard, one card in hand. And I'll tap down the Egon here. Struggle for Skemfar. So be it. Didn't have mana to pump it. So now I will just make this trade happen. They get one other turn with the Egon, but that really doesn't matter at all. I will take 3 now and 3 on the next turn, potentially. Well, now I do have the option to just tap down the Egon with the Berg Strider. Then I don't have mana to use this, but the 4-4 can block the 3-6 in here. And then the other option is to play the Ogre Raven and take the 3, and then I can lock down the 3-6 and start, you know, attacking with the... Yeah, I think I like it slightly more because I do want to start attacking with my flyer. Now the first pick in this draft has been doing quite a bit of work here. 8 is still a fairly safe amount of life. Okay, now they have the card in hand. Egon is about to die. They do get an extra draw. Ogre Raven. I think I want to play the Ogre Raven and just still tap down the Skemfar Shadow Sage. I don't need to have the 4-4 down now yet. Couple of draws for the opponent, and I have a 9 o'clock in the air. Priest with one snowland won't be mattering at all. That requires white, so that's... they have no white here. Interesting. And now I will just... say red here and play this and tap down the Shadow Sage. Okay, so that can be tapped down. I can force them to... Well, no, I won't be doing that, because I didn't... Yeah, that would be too risky. Let's see if I find my feet, the serpent, here now. I did not. So the thing is that I can tap down the Comas Faithful and then attack with all. They have to jump block the Berg Strider, go to 4, but then they can attack for 6 and go back to 7. So... it will be just a lot safer to attack with the flyers, and then I can tap down the 3-1 on their turn and win on the next turn. And I can, well, I can block the Shadow Sage, but then they can finish it up with the priest. Maybe I'll double block the Shadow Sage with the Scorn Effigy and Berg Strider. I don't care about their tricks really because my Ogre Ravens are lethal. They need to have a removal for the flyers here. Okay, that doesn't do anything. So I'll just tap down the Comas Faithful now. Ogre Ravens for the win. Yeah, the game is over, so might as well let go the next game. So is this deck something against which I want to have the Trickster Gods heist? I don't care about the Egon. Stealing Egon isn't that interesting. Shadow Sage is a 2-5, not that interesting either. Valky or Tibalt is there. Snakeskin Whale. The way down might be okay. Kills the Faithful, kills the Grim Draugr, kills the 2-2. Maybe I wanna play two way downs. I don't think I want to have the Trickster Gods heist, but I might want to have two way downs in here. Also kills the Valk if they play the creature version of it. And maybe the Scorn Effigy won't be that great. I haven't seen the Crippling Fear, by the way, in these games. It would be fine to see it once or twice. Scorn Effigy seems like the least impactful card to keep in here. The Demonic Gifts would work against in some scenarios, but well, it is quite okay as a response into Struggle for Skemfar, because it might even help me to win the fight. So let's see. It's also not so bad with the Elder Fan Disciple. And maybe I could not play the... it could be like the Thought Thief. Yeah, let's not play the Thought Thief. And this is the final sideboarding. Only two lands, no blue mana. Opponent does mulligan. I will mulligan too. I have the Valky and then the way down and feed. But without access to any blue mana, I don't like to keep that. This isn't a good hand either, but of course I have to keep it. Let's see if the opponent keeps it. They kept six and I keep six, and this is going to be a black producing land, unless I draw the swamp. Otherwise, I don't want to miss on the feed here. Although I think I have a turn or two to see if I draw the swamp. I might want to say red in there anyway, if I draw my Tibalt. Okay. Well, at least they mulligan, so this is potentially useful. And then let's see if they get a token out of this thing. I can just jump block with this and then use the way down. They just lost the land in there. Yeah, I might go for the jump block here. Let's see if they have an elf there. If it is the Comas Faithful, then I won't. Okay, Valky can find my Valkyrie in here. I have removal for that stuff. Yeah, I'll just go for the jump here. And then have the way down. If I had any other play for the... Oh, there's the swamp, by the way. So I can say red here. If I had any other play here, then I might... Maybe didn't go for that plan. But because the way down is the only thing I can do here, I want to just get dealt with it. Okay, they have a snakeskin whale there. Well, then they have that. At least they are very far away from 7 mana. That's going to counter the Feed the Serpent anyway, so maybe not such a big deal. I will take 5 damage here though. They are at 2 lands, 2 cards, I mean 1 card anymore. But I have 1 spell against their 2 spells. Well, I guess I'll get the Hailstone Valkyrie back. So the killing the Valkyrie would be nice, but it's just a 2-1. They can make it actually a Hailstone Valkyrie if they want to. Now if I could find another snowman, then I could pump the Valkyrie. Then I could block the War Master. Well, that thing deals with the War Master. I will kill this right away because they might have another Snakeskin Whale. So I will take another 3 here and then I can use a Berg Strider to block this. But they still will hit 7 lands at some point and that will be problematic. I think I did have another way down. Okay, they took Roots of Wisdom. They can find only a land. And it's a... Yeah, they chose the forest over the Pretagard Stronghold. Interesting. They need a third land right now. Okay, where there is the... another snowland. Now do I want to still go for the Berg Strider? I could play the Valkyrie and start attacks with in the air. I think I will do that. So this red, blue, okay, I will say black in here. I can take the 3 here. I'm just wondering, oh, they're not playing the land because they are, you know, I had these disciples, so they want to have a discard protection. That's the reason. But that means they also don't get to 7 mana that easily. They don't have a snowland for that thing. Well, how about that? I have only 2 snowlands myself, so that means I will play the Berg Strider first. But I will attack first. And then next turn I can Nafi. It will pump actually both of these. They are snow creatures. They are not zombies, but it's enough that they are snow creatures. Okay, so now they play the land. They are still 2 lands away from the War Master activation. And now I found my disciple too. Which I don't have to play right now. But I could. Let's say if I play Nafi right now, that will make this a 3 power. A flyer, this is a 5 power, that I would deal 8 damage now. But then I would have to block with the Nafi. That's kind of an annoying thing. I could also just play the Disciple and yeah, I can leave the Berg Strider to block too. That's true. Maybe I'll have to do that. I can play the Disciple and then pump this once. That's a possibility as well. Maybe. And then I leave the Berg Strider to block here. I kind of feel like I... Because I am at 9, I don't want to take yet any attacks. I can't really afford the Berg Strider. Berg Strider attack quite yet. So let's see what they discard. It was a land. So, let's see. Yeah, if I had a third snowland, then Afi would be so easy because I can just block with it and it will come back. Okay, that means they have something. Don't really have much. Well, I will just block here and see what happens. That's fine. That could be like a Jarl of the Forsaken. Or could be also erase the Draugr, but then again. If they can't kill the. Okay, yeah, they had to weigh down. That's definitely acceptable. So now actually, now that I drew an untapped land, I can play the Na'vi and pump the Valkyrie. So most likely, I am not going to block with the Disciple. If they find a land and make this menace guy, I don't think it matters. I have the choice to block with the Na'vi or not. I also have a lethal attack coming up, but if I block with the Na'vi, that's not going to be lethal. So it's an important question now that am I going to... Well, they have something to deal with my guy, apparently. That's still not a snow land for the Crypt Draugr. But they play to land and they don't have a snow activation up for this, so they have something they can play. I think I have to just play it a bit safe here, because I have a two-turn clock here anyway, with the Valkyrie. And I have a jump blocker for one of their ground guys. Okay, they played nothing. Well, there's no hasty guys there. Nothing with flash either. I guess they have a... They have some kind of removal spell. That has to be it, because they are having priority here. So let's see what it is. Feed the serpent or something like that. That was exactly it. But now that I have my snowland here, I can start bringing Na'vi back. That is fantastic. Well, that was just a matter of time, because I do have 7 snowlands in the deck. Might as well play this. Okay. That's gonna be... I'm gonna attack them to 1 now. And the pillar will basically seal the deal here. So I have won both two of my matches so far, but I haven't get to play Crippling Fear or Tybalt. But I guess the common and uncommon synergy here is enough. Opponent Mulligan to 6, I will of course keep this one. I don't have a 2-drop, but I have a 3, 4, 5 curve here, potentially, if I draw the lands. And this I think is going to be a black producing land. Because I do want to have the double black available, and I'm not going to... I wanted to play the tapped land right away. They had a foretell action. I can trade with that thing. And I will use this on myself. Crypt Draugr. It's kind of unnecessary. I have here 4, 5, 5 draws. I just want to maybe find my snowlands for the Na'vi. Okay, I will do this. Well, one thing to keep this actually would have been to play the Crypt Draugr and the Binding Monster on the next turn. But, oh well. Oh, there we are, mine. Tybalt went there, so I no longer need red mana for anything. I suppose, because I don't have the snow mana, I will just trade with the Breakneck Berserker here. It's fine. And then I can start doing the Berg Strider into Na'vi. Basically, I just want to find snowlands here. Okay, that can be dealt with the Binding Monster. But I think I'll just first I will Berg Strider it. Yeah, I don't mind trading resources until because at some point I will find my third Snowland, second and third, and then the Na'vi will be quite good, unless they have a feed and a serpent for it. Opponent still has a bunch of stuff. Okay, that was a good one. Scorn Effigy and the Scorn and the island. Would be nice to lose this, but when I don't have even the second one, it's too risky. It's gonna take so much time to find it that I don't need the Scorn Effigy for anything in particular. So here it's just going to be, I'm gonna say black because I don't need the Tibalt anymore. I don't think I have any main deck ways to bring back the creature, I'm pretty sure. They paused there for a bit. That makes me feel like they have a run amok in their hand. Because I don't think they paused for their priorities before this guy was attacking. And they had two mana up. Okay, they have a run amok there, I'm pretty sure. So they just... well, let's race here. They can Breakneck Berserker here. But I have actually... yeah, I have actually a two-turn clock in here. They have to respect it. I also drew the Snowland here. So, let's do this here. And then I will take here. If they play the Berserker, they counter attack with the Wall Dropper. I will take 3 down to 8. Maybe they have another spell. They have missed land drops there. But yeah, I think they have run amok in there. Oh, that's a very good one. But it's not gonna be that great. They can find... they have a creature here. Oh, Berg Strider. That is great. So now that I have a... I can force them to block the Dragonkin Berserker. With the Dragonkin Berserker here. That's pretty fantastic. Okay, they can find some cards with that thing. Not sure what they didn't do on their own turn. They could have found a land drop, but they didn't do anything here. They just scooped. Well, the Berg Striders are pretty good cards. So black red aggressive deck featuring a Skull Raid. The Berserker has to die. I will take the way down here. Do I want to have my own race the Draugr now that they have? Creatures might trade here quite a bit. I might discard stuff on the Skull Raid. It feels like the race the Draugr might be interesting, but I have no idea what I should. Sideboard here. I feel like the Crippling Fear will be quite good against them, but I haven't yet seen it in any of my games. I also think the Brian Barrow Intruder could be quite okay, but that's a lot of cards for me to now kind of... I need to lose 3 of these. The Hailstone Valkyrie might just be too slow against them, 4 mana 2-2. So I will lose that one. I think I can lose the Thought Thief. Although the Disciples aren't that amazing. So let's see, if I put Thought Thief back in and lose the Disciples. Or the one, or one Disciple, one Village, right? Or something like that. I do like the Village Rite if they have removal, but I didn't actually see any renewal. So let's lose the Village Rites. I will leave one Disciple here, I guess. And that's it. I definitely don't need the Trickster God's Heist. They don't have that impactful creatures in there. Well, there's the Valky and Crippling Fear, but then again, one lander, what's this? Well, Valky is here, but I'm not sure if I can... wait a minute, did they let me start? Because they did mulligan, but... okay, they actually let me start here. Interesting. So can I get the Valky into battlefield? Guess I'll just play the effigy for now. The 2-1 won't be having any impact in the board here. I would kind of want to wait until it... until I might hit the 7 mana, but... we will see. They have a priest too. So yeah, it makes no sense to play the Valky. I will just I'm not even at water with the attacks. Okay, well actually two more lands and I can play it. And I also have now the ability to get rid of the Priest of the Haunted Edge if they block. Because I have the double way down here, I think I want to get rid of my one of my creatures so I can use the way down at some point. Now they could have a Skull Raid, which is of course horrible when I'm keeping this Valky here, but I really think that the Valky can just win the game easily. Okay, one more land and that's it. I might just want to... oh, they could have a Village Rites though. But then they do, what can I help? Not much. I don't want them to have the Haste Giver in here. That's the thing. Okay, no Village Rites. Let's see what happens. I will attack now. That's getting killed. Well, they just want to have the Scry here. Definitely losing that thing. They scryed one to top. So losing that thing is not really... against the poison, the cup is not really a big deal. Plus now it's in my graveyard, so I can use my way down. Okay, Dugget Preserved. That's not gonna do anything if I find an untapped land very soon. Because Valky will dominate here. But let's see what happens. Okay, I can kill the token here. Come on, Valky. Okay, so... I'm kind of tempted to just play this Valky and exile the token, because the problem here is of course that they might find the hasty guy. If I plus Valky, it will be at 7 loyalty. Then it will be dropping to, of course, to 6, but then again I have the exile ability happen. If I exile the token, sadly I cannot cast it because it's, you know, just ceased to exist. So I'm worried that they might have the discard effect. Just if I do now way down here, I think I have to play the Valky, but I might actually... I mean, sorry, Tibalt, of course. Of course I play Tibalt. So now the question is, do I want to exile the... just the token? I think I'll exile the token. Hope they don't have a Frostbite. I will keep the Ogre Raven as a blocker if they have a hasty. Or if they have a hasty guy, then they can just equip that anyway. So that's bad. Because now I didn't get any value out of the Tibalt really. If they can just kill it. Okay, well that's perfect. Just equip with the hammer. Okay. That can be dealt with the way down. And now the Tibalt will win the game. And there's the Crippling Fury too, where that was. Okay, land. Okay, now I will start attacking here. I didn't get any value still, only two lands from there, but it's the truth is if they find a hasty guy, they can just equip it with the hammer anyway. So do I want to have my own Dusk Wielder? No, I think I will just plus this and play the Crippling Fear to get rid of that thing now. Make no mistake. I'm Bird. Okay, they got the hasty guy, but I have the intruder here, which means that my Valky will survive here. So do I want to... Now it would be dropping to 2 loyalty. I can make it drop to 4 loyalty. I think I'm not gonna block here, and I'm going to just blast this. Okay. I kinda hope to find some spells. Okay, I got a spell there. Okay, let's play the land. Grimdraugr, and then I can block this thing with... Well, I can play another Grimdraugr too. And I think I'll still continue the attacks with the Ogre Raven here, and... I'm going to block it so that... Yeah, I will block with the Grimdraugr and the Prime Barrow Intruder here. Just to absorb a little bit of more trample damage here. But I have really exiled a lot of lands with the Tibalt, so maybe I find a little bit more spells here. It's surprisingly hard here. Well, opponent drawing now a land is definitely good news. But okay, I drew a land, let's exile. Land and land. Okay, okay. That's actually quite nasty. Well, let's just go for the maximum damage here. I'm not sure how many snowlands I have, but let's activate it as many times as possible. Okay, they didn't even bother, so maybe that was their only hasty guy. Or they realized that even if they get rid of the Tibalt here, they are still going to lose to this stuff. So I could have the one more activation, they would have dropped to the 7 life, and then my next attack would have been lethal, even if they have find a hasty guy to deal with the Tibalt. So yeah. So I did find both the Crippling Fear and the Tibalt for the, at least for the last game here. And otherwise this was a 3-0 where commons and uncommons were in the biggest role, and I think the Berg Striders were, and also the Icebind Pillar were my quite important cards here, and the Ogre Ravens gave me a flying clock too. So I didn't need my rares that much after all. Alright, so this was good result, and I think I will have exactly one more traditional draft, and probably one more premier draft, and maybe one cube before Strixhaven. Yeah, I think that's pretty surely now the case. Next one will be a premier draft, then there will be a traditional draft, and then there will be a cube draft on the release day. Well, I will be publishing the cube draft on the release day of Strixhaven, and of course I will start playing Strixhaven and then uploading those videos as soon as possible. Anyway, thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye bye.